Morning.
The title of my synthesis this morning is The Development of Greece. With the full force of Asia, Africa, and Latin America, Greece takes on a truly global concept, meant for a truly global constituency for us. The intention is to produce products, product lines, and milestones, which are big, high-profile, innovative, visible, new, novel, such as new models for seed multiplication and seed delivery system, new models for jointly building extension capacity, new platforms for delivering agronomic, post-harvest, and processing innovations, new paradigms, new players, new challenges, and new opportunities. GRISP's vision of success is a series of quantitative impact targets, which are outcome-driven innovations through product-oriented R&D and partnerships. Partners are of two kinds, direct, strategic, and key. And the other kind are boundary partners. I really don't know what that means. Funding is the most contentious issue. Co-investment by partners in a contribute globally, benefit nationally style is the way to go. Donors are important. This is an understatement. Donors are very important. Scientists are important. Everyone wants to be visible as a working contribution unit with a specifically defined product, not simply a support or service provider. People are important. Who are the people in Greece? And how are they taken into account in this meeting? What will global sharing look like in Greece? If everything is new, where will the old fit? Where will I fit? In ThinkFive's logical framework, the expected impact is development of new technologies that fit farmers' needs. Are farmers' needs new? I have been told yesterday that ThinkFive, fostering improved policies and technology targeting to enable improved rice production and marketing, will move to be theme one. In order to satisfy the demand-driven, farmer-oriented production system focus of Greece. People, after all, are the reason for what we are trying to do. Research approaches range from the genotyping strategy, the high temperature and rice, sub-1 improved plus SF lines, resource management against resistance, in dealing with rice virus, heavy rice, to simulate rice diseases, constituted against inducible defenses as global research approach for disease resistance, Prince of Arise for Asia and Africa, multi-environment varietal testing scheme to learning alliance to accompany the open business model for post-harvest operations. But the most intriguing of all is Joe Rickman's 400 ex-combatant women in Burundi, where PBS, old farm demonstration, and farmers' field schools have been conducted. His battle cry is get technology to the target users. Quite interesting is the fact that Africa imports 40% of its rice needs. Someone at least beat the Philippines to the title of the biggest rice importer in the world. Arica, advanced rice for Africa, sounds like an appropriate name, except that Eli has stopped naming breeding lines it releases. It continues, however, to track down what it releases without naming them. Every presentation mentioned partners, without whom their work would never be done. But how are partnerships pursued? Are they the bearers of altruism or the faces of aggression toward self-interest? One hopes it is the former, not the latter. In doing what they are doing, one farmer hopes that we, rather than me, emerges. That is what a global program envisions. Thinking globally, acting globally, and benefiting globally. Of the many annual program reviews I have participated in, this one brought the most questions, the most answers, and the most curious expectations from the audience. Quite noticeable is the active participation of young postdoctoral fellows on the way to being the next generation of rice scientists. Will the varieties developed in China under the Green Super Rice Program be free to leave China so they can join other varieties meant for Africa? Estraza seed production and mini kit program for Swarna Sabwani in India, with partners like the state governments, NGOs, etc. Farmers training was also provided. Varietal tracking is being done using different approaches. South Asia is more than India, Bangladesh, and Nepal. Capacity building is part of every project. And I want to underscore this, because without capacity, you can't do your work. Technical working groups must have the reach, the ability, the system, and the credibility. It's more of an action group for knowledge management and dissemination. Eventually, it will be a self-sustaining program, characterized by examination, education, experience, and ethics. This CISA evaluation of early entries using direct seeding is a likely sign of the next revolution because of impressive results. The rice maize production system in Bangladesh are delivering developing, evaluating, and delivering SSNM technology. I am fascinated with the expanded version of success from 60,000 directly affected households to more than 1 million households. I don't know how you do that. More than 10 years of research led to science-based SSNM. Printed materials failed to deliver. Hence, we have the mobile phone applications. I wish there were actual cases from the field to report. It's also said that this is not for everybody. Expansion rice mapping and global rice information gateway. Why should IRI do it? The answer is very simple. Together, we know more about rice than any other group or organization in the world. I think that's a valid reason. And then we have the SSD knowledge base using household survey database, which is a gold mine. I believe it. It's a gold mine of information. And now for the quotable quotes. Well, believe it or not, heavy stress is here. Number two, business models should be location, technology, and actor specific. Another one from Joe Rickman. We cannot eat potential, but we can realize it. Another one from India. Partnerships are never easy. I agree with you. GRISP will enable us to have much greater impact in Africa. That comes from Africa Rise. And finally, cooperation and collaboration makes the world a smaller place. I hope that Sikandi is right. That's all.